You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI show where we learn, is your bot actually successful? And how can you tell? Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI show. Part two, we're going to talk a little bit more about bots. We've got Gary. Why don't you introduce yourself, bud?
Yeah, hi, I'm Gary Pretty. I'm a senior engineer on the Bot Framework SDK team.
Okay, so bots are cool. I played with them. They're really fun to like create conversational type of things. But how do you know if they're actually making an impact? Like, is it useful? How do you know if it's useful?
Yeah, it's a really good question. It's something that a lot of developers don't necessarily think about. They focus on building a great conversational experience, but then they don't necessarily always understand either that we've got the capability to track the conversation or that, you know, why it's important. And if you think about it, people have been using things like Google Analytics to sort of analyze their web traffic for years. Mm-hmm. It's something that everybody does. It's a standard thing because you want to understand which pages are being visited, which pages have got the drop-off rates, how long are people staying on the site, and it's the same with bots.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and if you think about it, you've actually got more opportunity with bots as well. We can track everything about a conversation. So how long is somebody taking between messages? Has somebody started a particular flow in the conversation and then dropped out? Did someone ask a question that the bot didn't understand? And actually what you can then start to do is, actually, if I see things that my bot is being asked and it's not answering, that can help me with things like backlog prioritization and what's the next feature that I need to add to the bot, or is something going wrong? So in the same way that we track our website health, we should also be tracking our conversational health as well.
It seems like it would be more complicated though, because I like intuitively I know how to track like someone lands on the website. Like I can do JavaScript-y type things.
Yeah.
Is there a similar facility to do that with bots?
Yes, and it's super easy. And it's just, I think, not enough developers know about it. And that's what we're trying to change.
All right, let's take a look.
Yeah, so I've got a fairly simple bot here. It's a flight booking bot. So I can say, book a flight. It's going to come back and go sort of backwards and forwards. So I'm going to go to London. I'm going to come from Seattle. And I'll go tomorrow. And ideally, we want to be tracking all of that information. And if we switch over to Visual Studio, I'm going to show you how really simple that is. So within your startup.cs file, when you're building a bot, this is where normally you're registering things like your state storage, maybe some dialogues, like we've got a booking dialog here. But actually, just by adding these few lines of code, so registering a new telemetry client, some telemetry initializers, literally by just adding this code, we start to get telemetry tracked automatically for us every time we talk to the bot. And that all of that data is being pushed up as custom events into Application Insights. Now, if people don't necessarily know what Application Insights is, it's an Azure service where you can enable it by default and it will track all things like CPU usage, memory usage for your application. But we can push custom events in there and then we can analyze it using tools within Azure. And hopefully we can take a look at it.
So a couple of questions. So for someone that hasn't built a bot, this looks very similar to ASP.NET MVC style stuff.
Yeah.
You're basically adding singletons that are going to get instantiated
exactly, or
used throughout the lifecycle.
That's right. So in the example of the bot telemetry client, we're registering that in our startup.cs file. And then throughout the bot, let's say you're in the middle of a conversation, the dialog is actually going to go and get the instance of the bot telemetry client. And it's going to use that to actually push information up to Application Insights.
And I don't have to write log events or anything.
No, exactly. If you want to, you can actually extend it. So you can send your own custom event or you can send your own custom trace. But actually, we've got a fairly substantial schema of information that we're capturing. And even if you're using things like Lewis for language understanding or Q&A Maker for, really straightforward Q&A type scenarios, we can add telemetry hooks to those as well with one line of code. And it's done. It just works. In this example, I just had a conversation with the bot And within Visual Studio, you can actually open up the Application Insights sort of console, and we can actually see all of the events that are being sent backwards and forwards to Application Insights. So bot message sent, bot message received are the standard events that you're going to see most of the time. And with each of those events, we're tracking things like the ID of the activity that's been received, the type of the activity, so that could be message, or it could be an event, or it could be a trace activity. We know what type of channel they're in. So again, just in the same way that we track what browsers people use when they're on websites, we want to track which channels are most popular, because most of the bots built with Bot Framework are in multiple channels. So you might have something that's in Teams and web chat. Well, actually, you really want to know if Teams is gangbusters, but nobody's using web chat. Actually, right. Why is that? So I can go and look at that. We get things like the username, and providing you enable it, because this is customizable as a flag, we can actually capture all of the text that's sent backwards and forwards as well. Now, you need to be careful with that, obviously, for sensitive and personal information, but it can be extremely useful in the right scenario, because you can start to see full transcripts, if you want to, of the conversation.
But make sure you tell people you're doing that if you are.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah, so now that we've seen the events are being sent up from Visual Studio, the next step really is for you to head over to Azure and start to analyze it. I did want to call out that we have a great doc in Microsoft Docs, just very simple, does what it says on the tin, add telemetry to your bot, and that's going to walk you through how you wire up all of the things that I've just shown you. It's a very detailed article, but it really is very straightforward, and we have a full sample in our samples repository as well.
We'll make sure to put a link down below.
That would be great, yeah. So if we, the other doc that we've actually produced as well is analyzing your bot telemetry, because telemetry is great, but there's no point throwing all of that data into Application Insights and then never doing anything
right.
Right. So this article is going to give you the ability, and it's going to show you how to use the log analytic feature in the Azure dashboard to actually allow you to interrogate that data. So we have example what are called Kusto queries. So this Kusto language, which allows me to interrogate the data in Application Insights. So here we've got a number of users per period, and it's got a sample query here where I can just grab this. And if I copy that and then jump over here, this is the log analytics section of my Application Insights resource.
So you go to Application Insights,
yep.
Log analytics.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah, cool. And then we're here. Now, all I've done here is I've said, show me all of the custom events that have been pushed up. And you can see those bot message received, bot message sent. There's also additional data, things like, has somebody started a particular piece of the conversation? Have they finished? But I can take the query that we just found in that doc. I can run that straight out of the box, and it's going to go and give me a really nice sort of rendered chart showing me the number of users in this particular period, right? So if we jump back to the doc, just to really call out a couple of things. So we've got users, we've got activity per period. That could be the number of messages, the number of dialogues that have been triggered. Then you get to some really interesting things further down. So, you know, how many times has a particular user visited? One of my favorites is dialog completion and dialog abandonment. So you definitely want to understand if you've got a dialog that's showing a very low rate of completion and a high rate of abandonment, why is that? Where are people dropping out? It's the same analogy as we use when we're tracking things like form drop-off on the web. You know, why is somebody not submitting this form when they've spent 10 minutes filling it out? And it can hopefully allow you to pinpoint things like UX issues. Because just as we have UX on a website, user experience issues on a website, we have the same, you know, conversational UX issues in a bot. So this doc is super useful for giving you some examples. And the nice thing to call out right at the bottom, we actually have the entire schema that we push up into Application Insights, which means you can then go and customize those queries for your own needs. The next step is we can take this query and we can actually pin it to a dashboard, an Azure dashboard. So this is great, the fact I can dig into my data, but I don't want to have to come in and copy and paste these queries all the time. So what does that look like if we switch over to the next tab? This is a basic dashboard that I built with all of those queries that we have out of the box in that doc. And you can see here that I've got my conversations per day, my users per day, which in this case are pretty similar because I was using the emulator, the number of messages that have been received. But then we start to see things like, you know, okay, I can see my waterfall dialog has got a high rate of abandonment. So I've not been finishing that when I've been testing the bot. But in a real world scenario, that would potentially point to a problem. And then further down, as I indicated earlier, you can also hook this into things like Lewis calls. So you know, what are the most popular intents? Why are people using your bot?
Right. Yeah.
So that's awesome. But then what if we wanted to take it one step further? And we actually have a Power BI dashboard that's available. This is available in GitHub. Again, hopefully we can put a link to the dashboard. And this is really information that we've taken from lots of customers that we've worked with in terms of what ideally would they like to see in analytics. So I've got my overview, very sort of similar information that I've just been seeing, the breakdown of channels that are being used. But then I can switch over to things like, if I jump over here to demographics, then I can actually see where is my bot being used, which languages have been detected from users. So it really does give you some incredibly valuable insights into user behavior when they're using your bots.
And this is pretty amazing because, I mean, I'm an engineer. I love to know if the stuff is that I'm writing is being, one, used,
yep,
two, if it's actually doing what I think it's going to do. And this sort of gets you to that.
Exactly. With very, very little work, you can actually have this. If you've got a bot there today, you can go and add this code in like 2 minutes and start capturing that data. And then you can analyze it. If you only need to dip in and out, you can use the log analytics dashboard with our doc. If you want to have something more permanent and updated for you, you can use the Azure dashboard. And then maybe if you want to share it out and use the, you know, the power within Power BI, then you can do that as well.
And it's actually kind of cool because, I mean, on Azure, you have multiple dashboards.
Yeah.
You might have one for your bot health. You might have one for some other bot. There's tons of stuff you can do there.
Exactly. And you could potentially aggregate these things as well. So you can see data from lots of different bots. So the opportunities are pretty endless. We've just tried to put in the framework for you to capture the data and then give you the tools to analyze it, but really not constrain you. The scheme is there. You can use it how you like.
So you showed an example in C#. Is this available in other languages?
Yes, it's available in all of our SDK languages. So you can go and plug the telemetry in JS and Python and Java, and you get the same data. It's the same schema. Although the implementation might be different in terms of wiring up the bot, everything else that we've seen today in terms of the Azure dashboards, et cetera, it's all the same.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching and learning all about telemetry and your bots. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.